When you want to add an image to your workspace, your design space for your Cricut, it accepts SVG files. On the presentation that I've shared with you, I've given you a couple of links to get some free SGV files. So if I click on this first one here and open it up. So if I just search for something, so say cat, gives you some options, lots of different options. So let's choose that one looks cute. Open it up, and it gives you an option to download the SVG. So that downloads onto the whichever computer you are using at the time. And then if I go into my design space here, back to where my Daisy heart and lettering are. Okay, so I want to add that cat onto here. Down my menu down the left-hand side here, the second one from the bottom is one that says upload. So these are things that I've uploaded already. Please ignore the it's 1 o'clock one. Thank you. And I'm going to click on where it says upload image there. So you can either drag and drop it onto there, or you can click on browse and go hunt for it. So it'll be in my downloads. Where's the cat? There it is. And it gives you this option. And when it's a SVG file, it's an option to cut it out, which is what we want. So that's what it looks like. Awesome. Plain, transparent background, clear image. Good. So I'm going to upload it. And that puts it in with all of these other ones that I've uploaded. So to get it onto your design space, you just need to click on it once. And it says add to canvas on the bottom right here. You're going to click on add to canvas and it will add it to your design after it's had a little bit of a think to itself. Here we go. So I can now pull that down, move my Daisy lettering around a bit, move that up, move my little black cat in place. Okay, so now you'll notice I've got three things down the right-hand side there. I've got my cat, black and white there, my Daisy lettering, and my heart cut out. And like anything else, I can turn off the ones that I'm not interested in looking at any particular time. So if I just want to cut my heart out, I'll turn the other two off. And if I just want to cut out my black cat out of black vinyl, I can turn the other two off. But it's a really good idea to keep them laid out how you want it to look using the colours that you would like to use through your Cricut machine so you can see it as it's coming together on your screen, and then you can just turn off the ones that you don't want to print out at any time.